today it's about Ketu in Swati Nakshatra. Ketu will move to Swati Nakshatra on 18th of October for next 8 months till 26th of June 2023. Ketu will transit in Libra from 20 degree to 6.40 degrees. Any change in the transit of Rahu Ketu are known to give some sudden alterations, mostly at the beginning or end of its transit. As Rahu is the head part of the serpent and Ketu is the tail part of it. Here we have Ketu making connection with Rahu as its Nakshatra Lord, who will be responsible to give the actual results. We may start a little strongly, as what we are strongly missing in the beginning is the grace of Jupiter. It is 12th from the transit Rahu and 8th from Ketu. So consciously using Jupiter's wisdom, optimism will be a savior to any problematic situation. See, the impact will be for everyone. Everyone must be going through some changes, maybe positive or negative. And Jupiter's understanding can be the balancing factor. We do not have divine guidance of Jupiter here because of its placement. Along with, there is an aspect of Saturn on this Ketu. Rahu, the Nakshatra Lord, is right opposite and in close degree with Uranus, the planet of suddenness. Mars will also make 6-8 relation with Ketu for almost entire transit of Ketu in Swati. We have eclipse coming up on 25th of October and 8th of November. Also soon, Sun and Venus will join this Ketu in Libra. And all these planets are an angle at 90 degree to each other, creating natural challenging situation, creating obstacles, delays on our path, and the efforts to get things done would be more than expected. You may have some unavoidable circumstances or event to deal with, but Jupiter is 8th to Ketu, so everything can end on a positive note. And Jupiter will work as a balancing factor in any chaotic situation. The last time this Ketu was in Swati Nakshatra was 18 years back, in March 2004 till November 2004. And previous to that, it was in August 1985 till April 1986. Do recall any major completion ending in life during this time, or some transformation or shift of events which carried an end to one chapter of your life for ultimately giving some good results. Expect similar type of major transformation with Ketu in Swati Nakshatra. The interesting part this time is this transit is very close to eclipse, which makes it more significant. See, Rahu Ketu are shadow planets, just the meeting point of intersection where the path of Sun and Moon cross each other. The impact they can have is on our conscious, our psychology, which can easily influence our actions. So it is very important to not lose our control over our senses and stay calm and clear in our approach. The best way we can use their energy for our growth is by adopting what Rahu signifies in our chart and release what Ketu is indicating. Jupiter in Pisces is also indicating the letting go approach. And they are two parts of one. They are Moon's node. So when Ketu is in Swati Nakshatra, Rahu and Ketu are working together as a team to achieve something and give some life-changing events. Currently, they are impacting the natural 1-7 axis. the purpose of this 1-7 axis of the natural zodiac is to bring balance to both the significance of Aries and Libra, harmonizing our needs with the need of our partner or whatever is in front of you is the goal. So when the purpose of Rahu in Aries is to gain independence, liberty, then the tool through which we can gain that independence is our close relationship, represented by Ketu in Libra. Rahu and Ketu brings new direction, a purpose in our life. With their placement in our chart or any connection if they are making with our natal or transit planets. With Rahu, new direction generates a way forward to fulfill our materialistic desires and is ready to take any risk to get there. Somehow it will reach its target. Whereas with Ketu, this new direction is kind of imposed on us by the circumstances. We are left with no choice but to take that path by some loss, letting go, leaving something or someone, or separating from our familiarities and get into the unknown. Rahu is our future, our ambitions, and we are heading towards our future all the time by using our skills and working on our desires. Ketu is our past, the gift that we are carrying from our past life, which can be useful to fulfill our desires in this life. In a way, both Rahu and Ketu are complementary to each other and work as a team. They complete each other. And when they make any connection with each other, then they are capable to execute major life goals. This Rahu Ketu connection can be very powerful to actually make things happen. Ketu in Swati Nakshatra makes Ketu a vehicle for Rahu to trigger events. Ketu will control any obsession of Rahu here. And Rahu is connected directly to Ketu for giving results and to complete something significant. They both here are ready to provide resources and support to each other and finish the task at hand. Ketu in Vishakha triggered a diversion in our life, and Ketu in Swati will conclude that, will give a finishing stroke. Saturn gets exalted in Swati, expects some final result of our hard work or rewards of our karma. Do not categorize the results as good or bad, as Saturn is the judge here to give results. Transit Saturn also has an aspect on Ketu, expect fair judgment. With all these explanations, I wanted to convey that this is the time of some major completion in our life. Now, Ketu is also connected with Venus as its dispositor, and then Libra sign, also Rahu as the Nakshatra Lord. And all these planetary placements are contradictorily connected with each other. And Ketu is odd match for Venus, Libra sign and Rahu. But they are together for a reason, for some purpose, and will put a full stop to something important in our life. The target can be to bring balance and harmony in relations by letting go and making necessary adjustments. Have a better social life by making the required changes and work in cooperation with each other. That's the goal of this Ketu in Swati. Ketu in Swati signals us to be cautious, to pay attention to nearly all the significance of Venus and Rahu, like relations, finances, our desires, ambitions in life, health, our spending, expenses, sharing, to be fair and just in our approach. All these should be evaluated and worked upon properly while Ketu is in Swati Nakshatra. Saturn's aspect will bring structure and stability in all these areas. Saturn will bring mindfulness in our approach. The Nakshatra Lord Rahu and Uranus are placed opposite to Ketu, which can give some dramatic, some sudden changes in the current situation. Venus and Libra both signify diplomacy and negotiations. With the combined impact of Ketu, there can be some sharp and cutting communication, which can bring some extreme but fair conclusions. Talking about Swati Nakshatra, Swati is ruled by Vayu, wind, and is a movable nakshatra. So it is connected with air, thoughts, knowledge, and communication. This nakshatra should be used very well. As the Lord is Rahu, be cautious. It can be destructive unless we learn to bend with the wind, the current flow of the events, and still survive the forces of any change which Rahu can create. Secondly, there are three properties or stages of Swati Nakshatra. It progresses in these three stages. One, it has the power to scatter all over like wind, as Libra and Rahu being air element. Secondly, while moving, it can have some change in its original form. And thirdly, as a result, have complete transformation and make a fresh start. So Ketu in Swati Nakshatra can cause movement first. It can give you some shift and then scatter to have the change in the status quo. Finally, to bring complete transformation. This can be both first destruction and then healing. So expect these kind of series of events with Ketu in Swati. Now Ketu will transit in different Navamsha. From 18th of October, Ketu will be in Pada 4 and Pisces Navamsha for 2 months. This will be the starting process of the letting go, some self-realization, time to be intuitive and not get into the detailing part of life, but to have go with the flow approach. Then on 20th of December, Ketu will move to Pada 3 in Aquarius Navamsha, which will emphasize more on the betterment of everyone involved. No personal gain, but to help others and everyone around us. As far as you think of the larger interest of everyone, you will find no difficulty in fulfilling your desires. Then from 21st of February 2023, Ketu will enter Pada 2 and Capricorn Navamsha. This can bring the most needed change in your work zone. From here, now Ketu and Saturn will be trying to each other with Saturn in Aquarius. So expect benefic changes in your professional life. Lastly, from 24th of April 2023, Ketu will be in Pada 1, Sagittarius Navamsha. There will be a strong need to reflect on your beliefs, go for some higher education, and change your opinions wherever there is a need. Observe the bigger picture and not to get bogged down in your everyday small matters. See, we are dealing with the natural 1-7 axis, Aries and Libra sign in your chart, where you are not alone. Others are equally part of it. It is all about you versus the rest of the world, creating ideas fairly, in a way that attempts to give justice to everyone involved or at least bring a balance. Strong opposition pushes us to go beyond our known limits, and that's the motivation for us to improve. And we have Rahu and Uranus in front of this Ketu. the results can be life changing but very progressive. Let us see the impact of all 12 ascendants. Wherever the Libra sign is placed in your chart, it's lordship, and the connection it makes with respect to your ascendant, that will determine the type of results that you can expect with this transit. I will share few keywords to focus on. You need to bring balance and harmony in all these areas by making some compromise or adjustments. Keeping everyone's interest in your mind, do let go wherever it is required and have a middle ground. Avoid any extreme approach. Also, be patient for getting success in completing your task. Know that you will find best closure maximum before the end of this transit. As I said, the results can be at the beginning or at the end of the transit. Start with Aries. Aries can aim to bring balance in their relations by some renewed belief and faith. Matter related to health, any personal, professional partnerships, business or travel can have some successful completion. Taurus, you may have new opportunities in your work zone. Any loan related matters, health, traveling to foreign countries or issues of some high expenses can be resolved. Gemini, you need to evaluate and develop some new passion. Matters related to children, long pending desires may see its fulfillment. You may have some good time with your friends and your network. Cancer, you should aim at balancing your family and work. Connect with your roots, build up your bonding with your family and have peace of mind. Matter related to home, property, vehicles can be settled with this transit. Leo, communication is the key. Along with expressing yourself clearly by making necessary changes in your rigid approach, you may fix all the issues related to travel, higher education, some movement or even settling your own thought process. Virgo, you may finally find that perfect solution on making a solid foundation for your finances, for your family and even bettering your good health. You can do this by adopting new ways and doing some required, most necessary changes. Libra, by end of this transit, you may find yourself in some new territory, new location. You may explore new options for developing stable connections and find that right approach towards others in your life and have balance, even happiness. Scorpio, you may finally be relieved from any pressure that you are holding on. This is the time of self-realization and have fresh perspective. You may be able to fix issues in your work zone and set your daily routine to have good health. Sagittarius, Ketu and Swati can bring great rewards and fulfill your desires, can give you financial gains, good money, new relations, development of new skills and habits, and these can help you to grow further in your life. Capricorn, you may finally find your dream home, vehicle, peace within your family, have successful time in your career, in your work zone, and you will shine well with all good public relations. Aquarius, you may find closure or new development for some transit, movement, travel to a new place, new adventure, learn something new. Your world view can be without any bias and you may have new plans to execute. Pisces, the change or the movement is at your doorstep now. With out-of-box thinking, some innovative ideas to work upon, some permanent change in the health-related matters, your eating habits, your communication style or the way you deal with your family can change completely now. That's all for all 12 ascendants. All in all, to summarize, there will be a certain end of an era, end of fresh start at some level before the end of this transit. Aries and Libra both are movable and odd signs. You may have to struggle. There can be challenges, but the movable nature of the signs can give you flexibility to go through that in a speedy way. Venus, the dispositor of Ketu, is a benefic planet, tries to give happiness and bring balance. Also, Libra is an air sign, emphasizing on proper communication. Any problem will have resolution with proper thinking and communication. If you will pay attention to your five senses, control yourself, and have a proper balance, you will be able to best use this transit to your advantage. The diplomacy of Libra will help you to resolve tough conflicts. Libra is the best sign when we are thinking about solving complex matters, as the approach is always solution oriented and bring balance. Follow the path of Ketu by letting go of everything which is unwanted in your life and which is kind of an obstacle on your path. Do this much and the rest will follow. Best wishes to everyone. Thank you for your time. Do write in your comments and queries, and I'll see you all soon. Thank you.